Hey folks, this is Best in Slot, and today we're going to do another animation showcase. This time we're going to be checking out the Indominus Rex. Now this was inspired by a comment on one of my last videos, talking about how cool the pack hunting is against the Indominus Rex. Because I mentioned the Indominus Rex doesn't use its arms as much as I would like in a couple of things, and it turns out it may use them when being pack hunted. So we have ourselves, this is an Indominus Rex, in case you're curious, and we've got ourselves some Velociraptors. Let's pop out a big set of 5 of them. Oh, right, yeah. My bad. Where are they? There we go. Hello, beautiful. So yeah, we're going to try this out, we're going to check out the pack hunting, but then we're going to try out some other things as well. We're going to see the Indominus kill animations, see what other cool stuff there is out there, see how much it... I just want to see a nice handsy dinosaur, basically, to be honest with you folks. So, let's see how this goes. We'll skip forward a little bit and hopefully see some really cool pack hunting animations. Well, I've got to say, folks, that took absolutely bloody ages. The raptors did not seem that intent on pack hunting the Indominus Rex until they are starving to death, which is actually pretty cool. That makes a lot of sense, and that's what you'd want it to be like. Let's see how they do. Yeah, the Indom is scratching at them, clawing at them. Oh, picks it up, grabs it by the tail, rips it off its body. Some of them, it just kind of rolls around and they fall off naturally. Let's see this again, see if we can see it grab. There it goes, very cool. And grab. I do love that animation. That's really awesome, actually. Whee! Have they been shredded? Well, all the ones that joined in have been shredded. Okay, what we can do. I'll let this one play out a little bit more. Okay, what we're going to do is we're going to use the power of Cryogenic. Slow down time, you see. You can see everything happens. Clawing at it. That one just kind of fell off there. Love the sound effects. Very dramatic. Scritch, scratch, scritch, scratch all down the legs. Indominus, you need to knock at least one more off. That's the whole point of doing this. Please. Indominus, please. No! Indominus! Oh, maybe it's not dead. He dead, bro? Oh, he's not dead. It's a toughie, isn't it? It's killed. A couple of raptors. We'll find out exactly how many at the end. God, they're in the worst possible position for the shadow, aren't they? Turn yourselves to the side, please. Now, this is the one he should grab, I hope. Seems to be struggling at the moment. They've worked it out that if you want to kill an Indominus Rex, what you should do is attack. It's kind of like Dark Souls, right? You attack at the booty, at the back, at the rear. That's got to be the kill, I think. Okay, well, I'm going to have to reload, but that was cool. But what I really want to see is that hand grab in slow motion. Okay, let's try this one again. All I'm looking for is that grab with the hand. It's when the raptor jumps really far forward, like on the sort of forelimbs of the Indo. It's going to happen. It's going to happen. This one right here. This one. Oh, maybe. Oh, that one's on the head. All right, watch the claws. Watch the claws. No, that one's just trying to bite at it. Might be this one. They're doing this on purpose now. They know what I'm looking for and they're determined to never show me again. It is primarily still using its head, as you'd expect. Come on, Indominus. No. Especially the raptors I'm relying on more than the Indominus. You can see how even when it goes for the head attack, it is dragging with its claws. It's trying to latch on with the hands. It just can't reach that far back. That one's pretty promising. Come on, Indominus. You can do it, buddy. I believe in you. Oh, that was like a... Oh, yes! Grabs it! Rips it down! Oh, very cool. That is exactly what I wanted to see. Awesome stuff. How dramatic is this? There you go. Play it in real time. Or speedy time. Right, okay. So let's try out a few more of those animations. Of course, we roughly know how this one plays out already. Lots of jumping forward, biting around, heads curling. Lots of... angry, roaring, that very cool little spinny spanny animation. That's what we're going to call it. That is the official term from now on. And Indominus, this is a hyper buff Indominus Rex. It's worth bearing in mind. God, it is a hyper buff Indominus Rex. I like maxed out its stats and it's still got shredded. Oh, good opportunity for a goat kill. It's still got absolutely shredded by the raptors, which is kind of annoying. I love this. Oh, makes me so happy in the most morbid way. It's such a good animation. Alright, okay. Alright, let's get this Rex fight part 2 on the go. Combatants squaring back up to each other, finally. Lovely stuff. Absolutely lovely stuff. One we've seen before, of course, but very cool all the same. Let's give them something else to try. Okay, we've got an Ankylosaurus. I'm hoping for a little cheeky animation here. The attack is a little bit of a shame because it is just biting down on the shell, you would have to call it, on the plating. Boof! Gets a good hit in though, the Anki. Let's try this a little bit of slow motion, eh? Little bit of slow motion. We have seen wait. Okay, we've got an Ankylosaurus here. It's already been injured, the battle, and oh, it's a headbutt. And the jaws clamp down around. I don't know where the sound went, but I don't know if I've seen that either. That, again, may well have been there in the last game. The new animation I'm trying to showcase really was the pack hunting. But the headbutt's pretty cool. Headbutt into the side to try and flip it over, basically. That's it's pretty sweet. I don't see a world where this ends well for little Cracknosaurus, but it is squaring up. It's giving it a good old college try. It's going to do its best. And the Indom still has to, you know, take it down the regular old way. No special animation for the Cracknosaurus. Just kind of gets nommed on the side. How could you? Look how cute it is, my friend. Oh god, that's terrifying stuff right there. No. No, Papa, don't eat me. Don't eat me. Okay, moving away now. Let's go and get a whole different direction than one I intended on. A Amargasaurus's turn. I'm always just very curious as to how it handles these various different critters. Jumps forward, clamps down on the back end. Just noms. Noms. Oh! Pulls it to the side as well, chucks it, launches it across. Roars in anger, clamps down on the head, directly on the neck. Getting a little bit of spikes in the mouth there, but what are you going to do? Nom, nom, nom. And in real time, if you're into that kind of thing, I'm not, I'm a slow motion obsessive. I'm not going to pretend otherwise, but here we go. Oh god, it literally launches the poor thing. Again, that might not be new, but I find that when I'm doing these videos, apparently I didn't pay that much attention to the animations back in Evolution 1 because I don't recognize all of them. Like, now I'm much more into it and picking up on them all, but a lot of these feel so new to me just because I never paid attention, I suppose. It's a whole new revelation. I'm going to assume Edmontosaurus is roughly the same as the Amarga, but we shall see. I don't know if that was actually a bite. I think he's going for it. It's very dramatic. Oh, it's just around the neck instead. Oh! Never mind, the launch is it's much, much bigger with the Edmontosaurus. That is a proper height, it just got it went. That was pretty impressive. Looks so happy, so pleased with himself. Now, I'm assuming this will be the same as the other large carnivores, but Suchomimus does have a fairly distinct size disadvantage, and Suchomimus has a lot of unique animations, so I thought we'd just give it a go anyway. But they are doing their regular old carnivore, jump to the side kind of thing. Combat in that sense hasn't changed too much in some ways, so... But that animation is very cool. I want to see that again in slow motion. We haven't done that yet. Let's try that out. There we go, that's what I'm looking for. Shoves the head to the ground, literally just wraps both hands around the skull and forces the creature to the earth. It's very cool, it's very Indominus, which is really what we want to see. Time to get the old Arkies hunted. Once again, we'll do this in speed. There it goes. Oh! It's actually quite similar to the goat kill where the hands come forward and they snap down on the spine. But let's see it in slow motion anyway, because we can. Although, that's only if the Indom actually catches up. It's a much better hunter than the Indoraptor is. Oof, clamps the teeth around the back, folds the dinosaur in half. It looks up, it's scared, it tries to run there for a little bit. Indom picks it up, claws at it once, claws at it twice, just kind of... It's not the same, it's not quite the same as the goat kill, where both arms come through and it snaps down on both parts. This is a little bit more ragged, a little bit more... Let's see it one more time. Thankfully, Indominus loves to hunt. Grabs it by the booty, knocks it to the ground, tries to get up. One claw comes down, other claw comes down, just kind of swiping at it really as it clamps the jaws down and gives it a good old wiggle side to side. Indominus really is a blessing, and how quick it is willing to hunt. The raptors really took their time, but the Indominus Rex being the violent, aggressive creature it is, if it sees something else in the habitat, it's like, oh, better go eat that. Oof. See, the headbutt attack is actually pretty awesome, and it makes more sense against, say, the trike than it does for some of the others. Not sure that makes sense. But I quite like that headbutt as well. That, you know, it's, the Indominus Rex does have a massive hammer off a head. Why not lead in with that? Knock the dinosaur over, weaken, get that soft, supple underbelly, and then take advantage. I will never say supple on a video ever again, I promise. Well, I was going to try the Cryolophosaurus one, but I did catch a glimpse of it just then, and there isn't really much to it. It's an attack and a kill, unfortunately. As you should hopefully see in just a second, bomb. Cryo goes down, one hit. Again, this is a mega Indominus Rex. It has slaughtered everything we've thrown at it. Other than the two raptors, oddly enough. What a coincidence. Alright, just a couple more I want to try. I just thought it'd be fun to see if there's anything special out there. And we've seen some pretty cool ones. It's about to go very wrong for this Pachycephalosaurus. It's kind of like, it just looks like the goat in the first game where they just stood there oblivious. Okay, they've decided to become best friends. It looks like it's birthing it. Now you run. Now we can kick off the anime. Okay. Let's try that again. That was quite a tame one. It's interesting that. Like, why is it... Oh. There we go. It's really interesting how... Like, I would have thought that and then maybe the Arky would have the same animation and stuff like that. But it's just a little bit different. It scoops it up and then picks it back up again and just gives it a real good shimmy shake. Figured we'd give Iguanodon a go as well because it's a little bit different. Oh, it was very different. Oh, hello. Okay, well, we need to... I kind of messed that up, but I think we need to see that again. That was pretty interesting. And a couple of seconds later, they decide to go back into it. And Indominus Rex walks towards Iguanodon. Oh, there we go. Drags it to the ground. Jesus! That's pretty vicious stuff. Just absolutely ravages the neck. Look at its feet. Its feet are amazing. Absolutely ravages the neck. Really... rips and tears at it. It must know that the Iguanodon is, you know, a threat, essentially. I need to see that in slow motion. I just do. Okay, let's see how... Oh, that's not slow. There we go. So launches forward, grabs it, twists the neck, pushes the Iguanodon onto the ground. Iguanodon begins to get back up. As you can see, Indominus Rex clamps back down and then just tears, rips and tears and rips and tears. And the entire body of the Iguanodon just falls around it on... It's brutal. I really like it. One more time for good measure in slightly faster motion. Still slow motion, but faster motion. There we go. Grabs the neck, twists, turns the Iguanodon onto the ground. You can see the hand plant as it begins to come up, and then it's just, it's so brutal, so vicious. Again, might not be new, but it's cool, and cool things are cool. You have a nap. You've deserved, you've killed like, let me check actually. Let's just have a little look here. Kill, yeah. 13 herbivores, 16 carnivores. It has been racking up the kills, to say the least. Deserves a good nap, I think. So I know we've seen this before, but I am curious as to exactly how it kills the Brachy. Does it just keep doing this same attack where it grabs onto the tail, darts forward, and grabs onto the foreleg? Is that how it's going to go down? Oh, the Brachiosaurus just kind of died. It wasn't even anywhere near the Indominus Rex. I think it's causing injuries, basically. I think there may not be a kill animation per se, as opposed to the Indominus Rex was damaged and damaging causes like internal bleeding or organ failure and stuff like that. And the Brachiosaurus eventually just sort of keels over and dies. Is it losing health right now? No. Oh, yeah, it is losing health right now. Interesting. But there's no problem. There's no... It dislikes the Indominus Rex, sure, but there's no ailment or anything here. It doesn't have an internal injury, but it's still losing health. So that's how they do it. They attack them once. It's like a venom almost, where the Indominus Rex attacks the Brachy, and then slowly but surely it dies over time. This is about to be very, very sad, but it's going to prove my point very well. Any second now, folks. There we go. Aww. Oh, poor baby, I love you so much. I'm so sorry what you've had to go through. Interesting, though. Interesting. You venomous on the sly. Is that what you're doing? You can't be trusted, can you? Can you? This is a weird little thing. I don't know if this was in the last game, but I've got myself a new Indominus Rex. And I got myself an Indominus Rex over here, and the starvation is turned on. They will starve to death. They're both starving to death right now. You can see they're both on low health because of that lack of food. There's no other food in the... in the enclosure, and they're not fighting each other. It seems that Indominus Rex has been coded to never fight another Indominus Rex, which is really unusual. I'm going to let it play out, but I'm pretty sure that's the case. I guess that makes sense, right? The same way that you'd have two T-Rexes together, they wouldn't kill each other for food. I just didn't think about it with the Indominus Rex. You'd always think about it as a single pack animal. Doesn't really make sense either to have a single pack, but you know what I mean. Yeah, they just died, unfortunately. Which, I mean, I guess means food for this Indominus Rex if it wants it, because the dead one isn't going to put up a... I'm not going to put up too much of a fight nowadays. Right, I think that's it for all the combinations that I can really think of for this. If anyone's got any alternate ideas, well, it won't really matter because I've already made the video, but we've tried... We've seen the small herbivores in the past. We've tried Ankylosaurus, Triceratops, those are the same, so I think armored herbivores are all the same, unless they're small, like the Crichtonsaurus, in which case they get eaten. Pachycephalosaurus had a slightly different one than, say, the Ornithomimids. Let me have a little look. I did one last little check, a bunch of coelophysis, and oddly enough, the Indominus Rex does not appear to have a hunting animation for the coelophysis either. I figured because it's a small carnivore, but it doesn't pack hunt like the raptors and dilos and stuff like that, and I'm going to assume this applies to the raptor, dilo, well, to the troodon as well, so the troodon and coelophysis probably. They just don't seem to have any interaction, so they can actually live together pretty happily, generally speaking, by the looks of it. They'll square up to each other and kind of spook each other. But once again, my Indominus Rex is starving to death, and it's not bothering to hunt the coelophysis. It's interesting, you can find these little combinations that work, and you didn't really expect them, but, you know, that's how it turns out. I kind of want to go see the pack hunting animation with the raptors just one more time. Just one more time. If I can get to a good angle, there we lovely stuff. Scratch, 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 scratch. Come on, Indominus, you can do this. Oh, fallen over already. I do like how the raptors kind of tumble to the ground. And you can see it, it's kind of like a turtle a little bit when it's on its back. It's trying to get up. It's kind of clawing at the air. I do need to keep moving the camera. There we go. That's the grab and the heave away. Very cool. Oh, that was enough. Okay, well, that's two raptors down. It seems to be okay handling the first two. It's the second two, for some reason, that pose such a problem. You'll notice how this time the raptors didn't immediately attack the Indominus like they did last time around. This time, though, the three of them are going in. I love that animation so much. It's so good. It's so exactly what the Indominus Rex would want to do, you know? Grab, heave away, chuck it into the hatchery. I've got to say, the raptors were kind of nailing it last time, but the Indominus... was wailed all over him this time around. Took a lot more hits that time. It had recovered to nearly full health, but it didn't have too many problems dealing with the raptors that time around. This is just one left, but I'll leave it there. It's a really cool animation. Big shout out to... I wish I'd got the name, but I didn't. I want to give a shout out to Nuno Gabriel, who told me about that animation in the comment section so I could show it to you folks at home today. It also scratches... You know, I take back what I said about the arms. The arms are used all the time, and they're awesome. I want to use them even more, but it's very cool. Yeah, big fan, Indominus. Well done, buddy. And it's one of the reasons the Indominus got such a high ranking in my dinosaur rankings is because the animations are just really, really cool, really custom, really unique. But a lot of dinosaurs have this. There's lots of interesting little interactions out there that I really want to test out. Maybe we need like a medium carnivore against everything else in the game to see all those different animations. And maybe we need... the other large carnivores, and maybe we need a small carnivore. You just don't know what's out there. The game has... I'd be really curious as to the actual numbers, because it feels like the game must have, like, you know, doubled in animations at the very least. It's kind of crazy. Anywho, thank you so much for joining me. Like the video if you did indeed like the video. Dislike the video if you dislike the video. If you're completely neutral towards the video and you're still here, that's a bit weird, but please throw me a like anyway, because that'll make me like you, and then we can go have eggs. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye. Oh, and let me know which is your favourite of the bunch. It's got to be the pack hunting for me, though. The grabbing of the tail and heaving it away is very, very cool. Anyways, I'm going to go. Thanks for joining me. Cheers much as always. Bye-bye. Reaching out.